product gut problem goes something like this. Consider you are the first person in the world to climb to the summit of Mount Everest, like no one did before you. Okay, what happens after that? You held an office called what? Historical superiority. That's it. You're the only person who climbed to the summit of Mount Everest for the first time. Do you think after you, 1 billion people climb, if they climb to the summit of that mountain, they will take away your status? No, case closed, right? Case closed. Keep that historical superiority in your mind and think about ontological superiority. So the assumptions that we're going to tackle here go something like this. Let me put it this. Okay, here's the first assumption. Keep the historical superiority in mind. If a strong AI gets realized, the machines not only would enjoy equal status with human beings, but they also can be superior to humans in many respects, in ontological respects. The second assumption is if a strong AI gets realized, then it would show the capability of human beings to bring about conscious beings which think and act like human beings, despite such beings having a biological or electronic substrate. But here are two assumptions, and I'm going to argue against each one of these assumptions. So the first argument goes something like this, and I'm not going to elaborate in detail. I told you about historical superiority. How about ontological superiority? Here is how it goes. Who created computers? Who designed them? Who is the bedrock of the existential status of the computers? What did it take for such devices to emerge and exist in our world? Exactly, you, the designer, right? So you're ontologically superior prior to them, right? So it took you for them to come into being, not anything else, all right? So therefore you maintain your ontological what? Which means this is not an issue that we should put it on the table as one of the options to debate over. No, case closed. It took me to bring you guys into being. Therefore, no matter what you do, the superiority gap is going to be unbridgeable. So no one could strip you of the status you have as being the first whoever climbed to the summit of Mount Everest, case closed. Likewise, case closed in your case. So you cannot really debate against that point. Olson provided conditions. What I'm saying is we don't need those conditions. If you really want to think that you can create conscious machines and bring consciousness into being, you've got to have a metaphysical property that would allow you to do that kind of thing. Like, do you have metaphysical property? God is a creator because he has a property to create the universe, right? To bring it into being. So do you have a metaphysical property? So you don't have. So therefore, unlike Olson, I will argue that this is not an issue that we should debate over whether we can be in a position to meet certain conditions or not. No, we don't have the metaphysical property to begin with. Therefore, we will never have that property to create machines that are as conscious as we are in the same sense. In other words, machines, because it took us to bring them into being, we are necessarily metaphysically superior to them. We shouldn't entice ourselves. They do incredible things, therefore they are superior to us. That's laughable. They do incredible things because we are incredible people who can make such things that would do incredible things. That's the idea. So the argument will never work the other way, right? A calculator can calculate a mathematical equation that would take you, that would have taken you literally a month to figure out in a matter of seconds. But who produced that calculator? Whose brainchild is that calculator? Who is the smartest here? Whose imagination brought that thing into being? Think about that, by the way. If you don't buy my argument, it's fine, but think about those things. So it really doesn't really make sense here. So we cannot give any credit for computers, but one thing we can do is we can take what Daniel Dennett says, we can take intentional stance. We can say a brilliant car, a brilliant computer, a brilliant blah, blah. We're taking intentional stance. In other words, treating something as if something is a conscious being, something is a brilliant thing or something like that. If you have a nice car, I think it's just a bit laughable to really say that, oh, car, I'd really appreciate you for everything that you're doing for me and for my family. Honestly, I'm going to take you to Hawaii. This is just so humbling to me. I'm so blessed to have you, honestly. You don't have to drive, you know, I don't want to use you like for a week. You just, you know. Does that make any sense? There's no we don't reciprocate this, but you can do that. You can take intentional stance, by the way. I love my computer, just John, the way John did. Like, I'm not going to smash my computer. You can take intentional stance. So therefore, that's the idea. Here is what EJ Lo says. Ironically, if we were to succeed in developing AI, that might provide the strongest possible testimony to the superiority of our own intelligence. Look, what EJ Lo is saying is, it doesn't matter how spectacular computers we might end up creating in the future, whose superiority would that show? The makers, not the products. Think about that. So here is my model. It's just not a mathematical model, but it's a nice expression, N plus one model. The N plus one model goes something like this. I'm still kind of trying to figure out expand its, you know, its expression. For any given step taken N, a maker is necessarily a step ahead, which means N plus one. So you will never catch up. Computers will never catch up with us. No matter what they do, we are one step ahead all the time. Because this is a matter of ontology. It's not a matter of technology or something like that. So therefore, here is my conclusion. The maker gap, the maker product gap problem remains unresolved given what AI people are saying. This will never be resolved because it's a matter of ontology. It is not a matter of technology. I would love to hear your objections, but when you bring up your objections, please show me that it's not a matter of ontology, which means here is the best way for you to attack me. Let me give you. You prove to me that it didn't take you to bring this gadget into being. That's the only way you can succeed in attacking my position.